Okay, this video is going to be about predictions for 2009, but before I get to my predictions, I want to talk about what's going on in the world today. First, Israel and Hamas. Yesterday, Israel hit over 20 targets in the Gaza Strip. They killed a top Hamas leader. Hamas is currently acquiring more missile systems, more rockets, missiles with a much longer range now. So now they're threatening really sensitive areas within Israel. One particular location, a nuclear installment in Dimona. Nuclear. Now, that word scares me. You know, apparently this power plant, this nuclear facility is actually within harm's way. So this is definitely something that's concerning me for sure. I'm definitely worried about this. So Hamas is acquiring missiles with longer ranges. In California, Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger is creating an economic plan. His plan is to try to close the budget gap. The gap is now projected to be $42 billion. $42 billion. His plan includes shortening the school year, raising sales taxes, and tapping into the state lottery system. Interesting ideas. I'm not sure it's really going to do that much good. He's trying to cut down on the labor costs. You know, the problem seems so huge now. I don't see how they're going to solve this. But even if the legislature agrees to this, California could still run out of money by February. So it's very severe, and it's an emergency. California is expecting the unemployment to exceed 9% in 2009. I would say it would go higher, but it depends on the sources you use to determine where the unemployment is going to be at. But anyway, the euro is declining against the U.S. dollar, and the European Central Bank has decided to cut its interest rates from 2.5. I don't know what it's going to be, but they're going to cut it. They're going to try to encourage people to start spending. Where we hear that from. But anyway, the auto industry, as you know, had a horrible year. GM had a 41% decline in sales. Chrysler had a 48% decline in sales. Ford had a 33% decline in sales. And overall, the industry suffered a 25% decline in sales. Even Honda and Toyota are seeing decline in sales. For the big three, it's been a 16-year low. 2008 was a 16-year low for the big three. And of course, oil had a really bad year, or a good year, depending on how you look at it. Oil had its worst year in NYMEX history, worst, in terms of a decline. So, that's the news for today. Now, predictions. Now, first of all, I am not an economic expert. I don't have an economic degree. My field is in somewhere else, in criminal justice actually, but I have been following the economy, and to be frank with you, after last year's round of predictions from the experts, I'm not afraid to give you my opinion on what's going to happen in 2009, simply because a lot of the experts on television and on cable news were so wrong. You know, those people were predicting 15,000, 16,000, 17,000, like huge numbers, you know. But of course, they turned out to be really, really wrong. So I don't feel bad about predicting something and getting it completely wrong. And let's hope I do get it completely wrong. Anyway, I expect unemployment, the measure U3, the official unemployment, to be topping out at around 8% this year. I expect a 4-6% decline in the gross domestic product. And I expect the dollar to decline, although I'm not expecting an epic crash like Peter Schiff is predicting, but the guy's been right a lot. So anyway, I'm going to show you some charts of my predictions, and I would like for you guys to rate my video, and please feel free to comment on what you think is going to happen in 2009. It could be political, it could be economic. I just want to hear what you guys and gals have to say about this. So here you go.